Hello everybody, in this particular video I am going to explain how you get the good rank in GPAD. So what to do to get good rank in GPAD? So this is my personal success formula what I am using in GPAD exam, and after GPAD exam I used this thing and I got a state first rank in Andhra Pradesh Pharma PG State exam, and I got all India fourth rank in NIPER PhD entrance. So I am going to reveal the complete strategy over here. So let's get started. So what to do to get the good rank in GPAD? Don't completely depend upon one or two subjects. This is the one thing I want to make you clear that, sir, what is meant by completely depending upon one or two subjects? Lot of students, including me, when I prepared for GPAD time, so completely depend upon two subjects, like their interest in pharmacology. So they completely read the pharmacology and they go with some topics of cognitive and some topics of chemistry. That is a major mistake we are doing. If you want to get a very good rank, I'm talking about the students who want to get the good rank, okay? So I'm not talking about the students who want to qualify. So if you want to get the good rank, don't completely depend upon one or two subjects. Try to read all the subjects in a comprehensive manner. So what happened if you completely rely upon the one subject or completely or two subjects? So what happened means there is a chance of asking sometimes difficulty questions from the subjects what you completely read. So that means you think that, okay, from pharmacology 28 questions are come, so I'm good in pharmacology, so surely I can answer 28. It is a very wrong assumption. So even the paper is very easy, you are able to answer more than 22. Not 20, only 22 questions only you are able to answer if the paper is very, very easy. Even though you read a complete subject of pharmacology, but still if the paper is somewhat difficult, there is a chance of answering only 18 questions. So out of 28, you are able to only answer 18 questions. There is a chance of getting wrong marks in this answers also. That means don't completely depend upon one or two subjects to get the good rank in GPAD. So that is the major thing I want to make clear. And read all subjects in a comprehensive way. For example, if you read five subjects like Sutics, Ecology, Cognitive and Analysis, so you read it in all the subjects in a comprehensive way. So you get some idea on all the subjects. So in the Sutics, 38 questions are given. So you have some idea on the Sutics. So there is a chance of answering even 28 questions maybe. And in case of Chemistry, 38 questions are given. So there is a chance of answering 28 questions. So in this 28, we can say some wrongs are there and something like that. So I will already prepared one formula. So what I used in the examination to get the good rank, so I am going to reveal that formula in the next slide. So you can able to answer the maximum question, you will get a good rank. So that means if you read it only one or two subjects majorly, so you completely depend upon those subjects, what happen means you are unable to answer the maximum number of questions. There is a chance of getting sometime question paper difficult. So if the question paper get difficult, it is highly impossible for you to get good rank. But if you read it more than 2, 3, or 5 subjects in comprehensive way, you are able to answer minimum amount of questions. That minimum amount of questions will surely secure good marks, and it eventually is a good rank. So now I am going to reveal the my success formula. So what I will do, so for example in GPAD exam, these are the different important subjects. So pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmaceutics, pharmacognosy, pharmacology and other subjects. So from here surely questions are coming every year. So if you take the pharmaceutical chemistry, 38 questions are coming from the organic chemistry, from the biochemistry, from the medical chemistry, even we can call analytical chemistry. So that means analysis. So everything, so all these topics covering 38 questions. So if you read all these topics in a comprehensive way, just think you read it only comprehensive way. And pharmaceutics, in pharmaceutics we have the dispensing pharmacy and modern pharmaceutical technology and novel drug delivery system, like the different subjects are there. Okay, you read it all the subjects in a comprehensive way, 38 questions are coming in the exam. Just for the sake of discussion, remember like this. And pharmacognosy, you read pharmacognosy 1 and 2, like alkaloids and carbohydrates, glycosides, whatever it may be. So 10 questions are coming, just remember, okay, 10 questions are coming. Okay, pharmacology 28. So you read all the subjects in a comprehensive way. You are not completely dependent upon only one subject what others are doing. You are reading all the things in comprehensive way. So in pharmaceutical chemistry, we are getting 38 questions. So out of 38, so there is a chance of you are reading in comprehensive way. So there is a chance of answering 30 questions. So in this 30, there is a chance of 3 will be wrong. So what is the final mark? So 30 questions you attempted. So 30 are right, 3/4 are 120. Right. So 3/4 are 120, you get it. So I think I gave something wrong. 3/4 are 120. But here what happening? 3 questions are wrong. That means how many questions are you answering? So currently 27 questions. right? So if you are answering 27 questions, means just subtract 12 from the 120. So 12 from 120 means 120 minus 12, you know, you need to do. So automatically you will get the 108, sorry. So you will get 108 marks. So in this 108 mark, you done 3 questions wrong. So what you need to do? Minus 3. So definitely you will get 105 marks. So that means in pharmaceutical chemistry, they are given 38 questions. Out of 38, so you are able to surely answer 30 questions if you read a comprehensive way. So out of 33 may be wrong, so you get 105 marks. And in the same thing with respect to pharmaceuticals, if you done the pharmaceutical also in comprehensive way, out of 38, there is a chance of answering 30. So there will be again 3 questions will be wrong. So again you get 105 marks. Another thing that in case of pharm cognitive, out of 10 questions, there is a chance of answering only 8 questions correctly. Don't think that if you read it even complete KD Tripathi book or you read complete Sika Kokate book, it is highly impossible to answer the every questions that are given in the particular subject. So there is a chance of missing 2 or 3 questions even by the topper rankers. So in pharm cognitive, you read a Sika Kokate, even though out of 10 you are able to answer 8. Or minimum number, like it is a minimum number. If you are good enough, there is a chance of answering 10 out of 10. Okay, so you are able to answer 8 here. So out of 8, 1 will be wrong, so you get 27 marks. And pharm cognitive, 28 questions, so there is a chance of answering, just for the sake of understanding, you are able to answer 22 questions. So 3 will be wrong in this 22, so you get 73 marks. And other subjects, so from the other subjects, you may answer 7 questions correctly. So in the 7, 1 may be wrong, so you get 23 marks. If you add all these things, finally we are getting 333. This is the only example I given. So that means if we read all the subjects in a comprehensive, for example, what I seen means one of my lot of friends, what they will do means they completely read one subject in detail. They go with the complete textbooks and they read the complete textbook, go in deep, and they spend a lot of time on only one subject. But in my case, what I did means I always read all the subjects in a comprehensive way. If I read pharmaceutical chemistry in comprehensive way, pseudics comprehensive way, cognitive comprehensive way, quality comprehensive, but they are reading complete one subject in depth. So there is a chance if they in pharmacology 28 questions are asking, they are answering the 28 after 28, they are good enough, so they are answering 25 questions correctly. But what I'm doing, I'm reading all these subjects comprehensively, so here I'm not able to answer 25 as like them, because they spend a lot of time on pharmacology, they are able to answer 25. But here I only answered 22. So what is the difference between them and me? 3 questions. But in pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmaceutics also, I attempted good amount of questions when compared to them, because they are wasted a lot of time on only one subject. That is the major mistake of a lot of students. What they will do means they completely spend a lot of time on one subject rather than reading the other subjects. So don't rely completely on one subject or two subjects to get a good rank. If you want a good rank, so read all the subjects in a comprehensive way. So this may be the formula I given, so there is a chance of getting good rank. And in the next video, I'm going to explain how you need to attempt the questions in GPAT to get a good rank and how much risk you need to take to get the good rank in GPAT. Thank you. I hope you understand.